Sapphire, my daughter, but not really any sort of chatting one. So yeah, I had an amazing time, I just have to tell you. Oh my God, what a journey as well, you know, absolutely crazy. It was quite a journey just to get there, you know, physically. You know, that's, you know, also the encounters that we had with drunk people laying all over the floor, and we could get by with our case, you know. We had a heavy, I had a laptop to carry, I've got back problems, as you know, and, you know, trying to drag a suitcase is not easy with one hand. And Saffy was the same, and basically they just lay in the road, and Saffy just made me laugh, she just dragged it on over their legs. They wouldn't move, they didn't, I don't think they felt it, I think they were anaesthetised, to be honest, with the amount of alcohol they seemed to have consumed. That was that. Then having that lovely crusty burger and then Saffy getting ill within the next hour or so, was not nice, bless her little heart, which, you know, could have really messed up the whole time that we had. Luckily, she's such a little soldier, and I think she's actually realised how tough she is. You know, I knew she was pretty tough, and you know, she's got a lot of affection for me. Obviously, because I'm her mum, but you know, she knew. So I've got to fly. She knew how important this concert was to me. You know, I was just so excited. I'd missed it the year before, and she, you know, when she got ill, she must have thought, oh no, you know. I can imagine just thinking, I can't believe this. I feel like mummy's just not destined to actually see this man sing. But no, she didn't make it my problem. And she insisted that we just keep upbeat and, you know. Sorry. The emotions. That we kept going. And it was a tribute to her, really. She was absolutely amazing. She kept her beautiful smile on her face. Couldn't believe it. And then, whilst in the concert, it just settled in our seats, we met some beautiful ladies. I think, yeah, one of them's a fan anyway, and she's on David Phelps' website. Any of you interested in that, by the way, who don't know? Just put in davidphelps.com and you'll see his website. Pop on there, have a look around. And she's on there. We found out that together. Her name is Judith, and her sister is Janice. So Janice and Judith. So hi to them if they see this, which I doubt, but still. They were lovely, and we had such a giggle, we really did, and three of us got up and danced. You know, it was just crazy. You know, just three of us. Nobody else got up. We thought, let's just get up and dance. We started singing out loud to each other, and it was just a riot. It really was so funny. Me, Saf, and Judith, it was. And yeah, just had a great time. There was a lot of people there in Ireland that knew Saffy. I didn't know that people knew her in Ireland, from Riverdale. Didn't have a clue. No, I think Seppi did either. Yeah, so that was a bit of a shock, because we thought we wouldn't be able to go there, we're anonymous, and, you know, mother-daughter kind of thing. But no, she had a few girls followed her to the toilet. Yeah, the portaloos, they followed her to the toilet and stood outside whispering, and, you know. So obviously, you know, she couldn't do what she wanted to do. So she had to leave, which wasn't very pleasant for her because she wasn't well. But yeah, we had that afterwards, and then it was, we was expecting a whole lot of cabs to be outside the venue when it finished at night, to take us back to the hotel. Of course there was none, not one. Anywho, we was left standing there thinking, how on earth are we going to get home? Anyway, I prayed, quick prayer. I said, Lord, you know, I need to get this girl back to the hotel. She's not well. You know, I had a word with him and left it in his capable hands. And I just walked over to this couple that were talking to somebody, and I asked them if I had a cab company or cab number or whatever. Because we did have a number for a cab, but it was a cab people that had come all the way from Ballymena to collect us. And we didn't really want to call them all the way. It would have taken me an hour for them to get there and to get back. And we would have been in bed, gone midnight. So I asked these people, and they said that they're going to Ballymena. Couldn't believe it. This Irish couple, amazing, lovely people. And they drove us to the hotel. It was a scenic route, lovely. You've seen it probably on the vid. But anyway, yeah, so we had a, you know, God answered our prayers, even got us home, you know. And David was astounding. He looked beyond my fault. I can't even express it, how much I love that song, the way he sings it. And the way he sung it that night was amazing. I just loved it, I really did. I can't really, I've run out of adjectives, and you know, no words seem to cover it. It was at a really nice sort of spiritually deep level for me. Amazing. I just wish that I'd been able to have a better quality. You know, I've had a tripod and I could have put the camera on top and focused in, you know, because it's jumping. Because I was only having to hold my arms aloft for like 8 hours, and my hands were starting to shake, you know, the way they do. So, and I had it zoomed in, trying to see the expression, you know, when you sing songs and whatever, and it kept jumping, and then it would drift off to the other side, and you'd be thinking, oh gosh, what am I looking at now? So it was all very, anyway, I hope it didn't spoil it too much. But, yeah, so I think that's it for now. I hope that I covered what I wanted to say. Anywho, David Phelps, I don't even know if you ever see this, I doubt it. But if you are, by some bizarre fluke, thank you so, so much. It's amazing, and it really was, you know, worth the trip, worth the flight, worth it, really. It was amazing. And I hope to get to see you sing again. And anybody else who doesn't know David Phelps, check him out. You don't know what you're missing. If you're a Christian, check him out. You've got to check him out. You really have. It's an amazing talent. It really is. Anyway, that's me out. I've got to go because my tea's getting cold. And I'll talk again soon.